If you are trying to conceive, the most important information that you want to know is when ovulation is approaching and when ovulation has happened, so you can time sexual intercourse to increase your chances of pregnancy. Ovulation predictor kits, also known as OPKs, are tests that can predict that ovulation is approaching, which is why these tests have increased in popularity. In this video, I'm going to teach you how to use the ovulation tests accurately and how to interpret the results to avoid confusion. By the end of this video, you will understand what the ovulation kits are testing for, why that is important to know if you are trying to conceive, how to use them, and when in your menstrual cycle to use them. I will also cover the most asked questions I get in consultation with women who are trying to conceive. So before we get into it, I think it's really important to note that ovulation tests show best results and are more reliable if you have a regular menstrual cycle with the cycle length anywhere in between 21 to 35 days. These tests can still be helpful in people with longer cycles, irregular cycles, or even in PCOS. They just might not always be 100% accurate. So you may need assistance with interpreting the results, but not all of the information in this video is correct for you if you have irregular cycles. I will make a future video that is specific for these circumstances. So if you'd like to know when new videos are released, hit the subscribe and notification bell. Types of ovulation tests. There are two types of ovulation tests. So type one, it's like a pregnancy test. You remove the cap and you pee on the stick. And then as the urine is absorbed, you can see that there is a control panel here. And one section is for the control line and the other section is for the test line. The control line is to show that the test has worked and the test line is testing for the hormone in your urine. Now these tests are more expensive. For example, this box of seven costs $15 Australian, and this was the cheapest box on the shelf. And considering that you will always need more than one test per cycle, this will surely add up over the months at more than $2 a test. And type two, the second type of ovulation tests are these test strips here. These are very simple, but as effective as the first one that I discussed. With these strips, you first need to pee into a clean and dry cup and hold the strip in the liquid no further than the max line for about 15 seconds. You will see a dye move up the strip and then place the strip on toilet paper and wait 5 to 10 minutes for the control line and the test line to show up. They say that the test results aren't that accurate if you are reading the results after the 10-minute mark. So be sure to set a timer so you can check the results around that 5-minute mark. And these strips here, these are much cheaper. For example, at the time when I was purchasing these strips, I could get 50 of them from anywhere in between $12 to $38 Australian. So I recommend these strips simply because of the price, as they both test for the same hormone and give you the same result. It is likely that you could use 5 to 10 of these strips per cycle, especially when you first start out tracking ovulation. These strips are especially worthwhile if you have longer cycles, as you are less concerned with how many you use because they are so cheap. What do ovulation kits test for, and what information does this give us? These test strips or kits are testing for your luteinizing hormone in your urine. Luteinizing hormone, which is also referred to as LH, is secreted by your brain, and the LH communicates with your ovaries, telling them to release an egg. So the LH hormone is what causes ovulation. In past videos, I use diagrams to help demonstrate the hormones and how they communicate with one another, which shows you the significance of the hormone LH in your menstrual cycle, and of course, why it's useful to test for this hormone when you're trying to conceive. And I'll link these videos in the cards and in the description box below. But briefly, the hormone messaging system works like this. The follicles in your ovaries produce estrogen, and as estrogen reaches its peak level in the blood, it then signals the brain to release luteinizing hormone, and the LH is what then causes ovulation. And a common question is, how long after you get a positive LH test will ovulation occur? And of course, this is different for everyone. After the LH surge, ovulation can happen anywhere from 6 to 72 hours, but most people will ovulate within a 24-hour window after a positive LH test. The important point that I want to make here is that estrogen peaks and causes the release of the luteinizing hormone, and both of these take place before ovulation has happened. A positive ovulation test means that the luteinizing hormone is surging, and now we know that it is the luteinizing hormone that causes ovulation. The biggest misconception about ovulation tests, these ovulation predictor kits do not confirm ovulation. It is true that you cannot ovulate without a LH surge, but just because you have a LH surge does not mean that you will 100% ovulate. So there is no way that you can confirm ovulation using the ovulation tests or the LH test strips. And to be honest, this is a good thing. Your egg only survives for a maximum of 24 hours after ovulation. So if you do confirm ovulation, you may have missed your chances of trying to conceive for that menstrual cycle. To confirm ovulation, you will need to chart your basal body temperature, and after 3 consecutive temperature increases, ovulation is then confirmed. And I go into more detail about your basal body temperature in a previous video, which I will link in the cards and in the description box below. To summarize, the ovulation tests are actually testing for the luteinizing hormone in your urine, and this then predicts that ovulation is approaching. If you are trying to conceive, it is much better to predict that ovulation is approaching because the sperm can survive inside the reproductive tract for up to 5 days. So this gives more than one opportunity to get the sperm where they need to be at the exact time of ovulation, and this is especially important because the egg only survives a maximum of 24 hours after you have ovulated. How to use ovulation test strips. First, you will collect your urine into a cup that is clean and dry, and you will dip the stick in to the max line. So don't dip the stick in any further than that max line, and you will hold it there for about 15 seconds. You will then see the color or the dye run up the stick and it'll move past the max line. You can then wait for the excess fluid to drip off and place the test strip on a piece of toilet paper and wait for the control and test line to show up. Most instructions on the packaging say to wait anywhere from 3 to 8 minutes before you can confirm if you have a positive or a negative test result. But they do say you cannot rely on a test result that you are reading 10 minutes after you've taken the test. So set a timer and know that your results are reliable if you read them around that 5 minute mark. And always use the packet information to confirm which one is the control line. This is the line to know that the test has actually worked. And which is your test line, which is the line testing the luteinizing hormone in your urine. And compare your results with the packaging that tells you if you have a positive, a negative, or an invalid test. And if you see 2 lines on your ovulation test, it means you are getting closer to ovulation. But as the packaging will indicate, if your test line is lighter, even slightly lighter than the control line, your test is a negative. This is where some people come unstuck, where they'll read this as a positive result and then they'll read the test wrong. If the test line is slightly lighter than the control line, it does indicate that you have luteinizing hormone in your urine, but it is not the surge that we are looking for. And to know when your ovulation test is a positive, when you see 2 equally dark lines or the test line is darker than the control line, you have yourself a positive ovulation test. Your positive LH result means that you will ovulate over the next day or two. And as discussed before, most people will ovulate within a 24-hour window after the LH surge. But ovulation can vary anywhere from 6 to 72 hours after you see that positive test result. And what do you do after you see a positive ovulation test? This depends on what your goal is. If you are trying to conceive, this is the time within your menstrual cycle where you want to be having intercourse daily. So the sperm can live inside the reproductive tract for up to 5 days. And as we now know, the LH surge means that you will ovulate within the next 72 hours. And this is when you want to give the sperm the chance to get to where they need to be at that moment of ovulation. Once the LH surge has been detected, you are now in your most fertile time in your menstrual cycle, and your chances of conceiving are at their highest after your positive LH test. So get to it. When in your menstrual cycle should you start using the ovulation test? And this will be different for everyone because everyone has a different length menstrual cycle. If you are new to charting your cycle, it could be a good idea to start using the ovulation tests immediately after your period finishes. And this is why I prefer the cheaper test strips, because you are less concerned with how many you use. By testing after your period, you can see the progression of the LH test results and then notice what day in your menstrual cycle you get a positive LH test when you see those two equally dark lines. The closer to your period you test, the LH test line is likely to be lighter, and as you get closer to ovulation, the LH test line will get darker. Now, if you have a regular menstrual cycle of around 28 days, I do recommend you start using the LH test strips from around day 9 in your cycle. And to be even more specific, start using the ovulation tests as soon as you see changes in your cervical fluid. And for more information about this, please check out my previous video that I'll link in the cards and the description box below. Get pregnant faster. To get an accurate ovulation test result, you want to make sure you are using the LH test strips a few days before ovulation. If you have been using a period tracking app for some time now, this will give you estimates on your ovulation day. So you could use the estimated ovulation day, rewind 4 or 5 days and start using the ovulation test strips from then. Once you have been using the ovulation tests for a couple of cycles, you will absolutely adjust when you start using these LH test strips based on the pattern of your previous LH surges. And when to stop using ovulation tests. In a regular menstrual cycle, there is no need to keep using the ovulation tests after you have seen a positive test result. But if you do, you will see the test line get lighter again. It is common for people to keep testing until that line gets lighter. I guess most of you like to know that you are past your LH surge. So if you have a regular menstrual cycle, as soon as you see those two equally dark lines that confirm a positive LH surge, you can stop testing. And once you see that positive test result, now is the time to have intercourse daily to increase your chances of pregnancy. And what is the best time of day to use ovulation tests? The best time of the day to use the LH test strips is between 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. If you test first morning urine like you do with the pregnancy tests, you are likely to get a false negative. And this is because the LH is usually released from the brain into the blood first thing in the morning. And this hormone takes time to be metabolized through the kidneys and into the urine, which is where you test for the luteinizing hormone. But it's probably no use using the LH test strips before 10 a.m. And I understand that work will get in the way for some of you, and it is okay to also test in the afternoon or the evening after using this test with hundreds of women, helping them trying to conceive. Most can identify their LH surge when testing in the evening. Now, it is recommended to use the ovulation tests at the same time every day, but this is often not possible when we're living our normal lives, and most often the LH surge is still detected. Excessive water intake can skew the results sometime and dilute the hormone more, so try to be consistent with your daily water intake. But don't get stuck on these factors. Just start giving it a go, start testing, and if you notice that you are getting mixed results, maybe then start paying more attention to these factors. Should you test your luteinizing hormone twice a day? If you see a test line that is almost as dark as the control line, you could potentially do another ovulation test later that day, because it is possible to ovulate as close as 6 hours after a positive test. Some people really don't want to miss that 6 hour window. The majority of people have a gradual surge of LH, where you gradually watch the test line get darker over the days leading up to ovulation. Some though can have a rapid LH surge where the LH peak happens really quickly, which can then be hard to test at that moment of the surge. These are the circumstances where it can be useful to use two ovulation tests in one day, especially if you missed your LH surge the previous cycle. This allows you another chance that day to see the LH surge and catch that rapid rise. But regardless of whether you see a positive ovulation test result or not, the advice for when to time intercourse when trying to conceive remains the same as my previous video, linked in the cards in the description box below. If you have a regular menstrual cycle and you now see cervical mucus and two lines on the LH test strips, now you want to be having intercourse every second day. And when your cervical mucus changes consistency and now shows you a fertile quality and you see the two equally dark lines on your ovulation test, now is the time to be having intercourse daily until you confirm ovulation. Remember that the ovulation tests are only predicting ovulation is approaching. It is the basal body temperature tracking that will confirm ovulation, and all that information is right here in this video for you.